Hi. Everyone, thanks for sticking around. Brian Moyles, work for Netflix Engineering Tools. As you guys probably heard earlier, in case you didn't, we basically build things for Netflix that help developers get things done. Last year, we decided it would be a great idea to start moving our build infrastructure into the cloud to better deal with scalability problems and sort of adapt things to the way that we do things at Netflix. It's important to note that at Netflix, you're pretty much QA release engineering DevOps on call. You're actually physically shoveling bits into fiber optics to move movies down there. We do it all. Each team really is kind of an independent unit that controls their own destiny. We give them a little bit of assistance with tools and solutions that help them get things done. But by and large, you are responsible for everything. And what that means is when things break or when you need to build at 4 a.m., it had better just work. And we all know that this is the real cloud, not this. It's more like that. So what we needed at the time, you know, of course, the cloud is ephemeral. And if you don't really think of it as such, the agents of chaos here will definitely help you out with that. We really wanted a fixed fleet of slaves that were always on for instant building. We couldn't really have any lag waiting for a node to be provisioned. We wanted whatever we ended up with to deal with that. Don't page me if a build node disappears. Just bring up another one, replace it. I don't want to think about it because I need that 20 minutes of sleep. And we really needed to be close as hands-free as possible, you know, with slaves coming and going. Some teams have specialized needs. We don't want to have to micromanage that for them because we've got bigger fish to fry, really. You know, we figured a good way to manage that would be to use some Amazon functionality we've spent the last few years wrangling with our Asgard console. Slaves essentially go into an Amazon autoscaling group, which are clusters of redundant nodes that automatically are managed by Amazon. If nodes disappear, they'll get replaced. If you need more, you say, hey, Amazon, this is how many I want. Or if I have this sort of load event, please scale it up to this size. But now we've got to give Jenkins EC2 credentials. We've got to make it aware of EC2. We've got to make it aware of our internal conventions. Let's just make it simple. Let the slaves register themselves. They're going to come up automatically anyway. Why can't they just reach out and say, hey, I'm here? So we've got the Dynaslave plugin. We took the Swarm plugin as inspiration. We looked around and said, you know, this thing really is like almost there, except it's got this whole UDP thing that really doesn't fit in our environment, and especially given some of the constraints we were under at the time, without VPC, without a few other things that make things nice today. So we used that as a base, and we ended up with what we have today, the Dynaslave plugin. It merely, and it's very, very simple, it merely exposes a URL that slaves can pull and say, hey, Jenkins, I'm alive. I need some work. These are how many executors I can support. These are the labels I want. Things of that nature. It's really, really simple. Right now, we use a script to push out some bits that might change on the slave nodes, and then start up slave jar after Jenkins creates its internal representation, after we pull that URL. It really allows us to get to the point where we can almost triple the size of our build fleet in, you know, 5 to 10 minutes, depending on how far those images have drifted since we built them and refreshed them. It's pretty nice. You know, no presentation is complete with some sort of diagram. So, you know, pretend you're seeing auto-scaling groups here configured to use a standard image that we've assembled for all slaves to use. And again, auto-scaling groups are given meaningful names. If we tell the slaves about those names, hey, we can use that as an identifier and say only tie. We could use that as not only an identifier, we use it as a label on there. So now we have this auto-scaling group convention where the name of the group determines the label that the slaves get, and then we tie builds to those labels. Pretty simple. If node dies, Amazon relaunches. If we want to scale up for a big event we have coming up, we say, hey, Amazon, add some more nodes, and 5-10 minutes later, we've got more. Maybe we down the road, we'll have Jenkins tell Amazon that we've got a backlog of jobs for a given label, and we can use some more horsepower. When we're quiet, we can say, hey, Amazon, don't launch nodes at 4 a.m., because we're just not going to be building here. We can also do that through Asgard. Again, that's a very awesome product. Check it out on our GitHub site. And in case it wasn't completely obvious, I mean, one interesting byproduct is that the plugin really doesn't really have to know anything about Amazon or any cloud. I mean, you could use this in your data center. You could use this anywhere. If you can hit a URL, you can run a JVM. You can use a Dynaslave for the most part. You really don't have to do anything with plugins, anything like that. Mars rover, if it runs a JVM, you could probably build on Mars, which would be pretty cool. So it's really, really simple. It's been useful to us, and we'd like to give it out and let other people give it a spin and hopefully help us make it better, because for all the ideas that we've thought of, I'm sure everybody out here has thought of 5 other cool uses and ways to extend it. We were already thinking of things like actually using the built-in cloud abstractions within Jenkins to help us handle grouping and automatically scaling things better. But you know, right now we're handling all that stuff in Groovy scripts, and it works pretty well. So you know, there's not a lot of pressure to do that, but it's something that would be a nice to have and would actually make some things a little bit more convenient. And there, like I said, there are likely other things that we haven't even thought of that we could use this for, and hopefully you guys can help us out. So pull requests are welcome. You can take a peek today at this URL. We'll be working with the Jenkins development community to get it up under the Jenkins repo and get everything set up the way it should be. And as always, further reading, take these links here, and they will lead to happiness and prosperity. They contain all you seek. We're hiring. Check us out on Twitter. Check out our slide share. Definitely check out the code. It's very, very, very simple. And ready for you guys to give us a hand. And again, thank you to all the sponsors for letting us talk about it. Any questions?